Hey Pat, it's Midnight Designer and we are back playing 7 days today. And in our last episode, it definitely wasn't day 9. It was day 3, I think. But we logged off and other people played and it has advanced to day 9. So that is going to be one of the challenges we have on this multiplayer server. Is figuring out how to balance all of that, because we want this to be kind of an organic world, but because 7 Days to Die is a sort of progressive difficulty game, so that, you know, for example, the day hordes get worse as time goes by, it'll be hard to kind of balance that with you know, everybody being able to get on, do their own thing and things of that nature. So let's see here. So I'm just trying to do some stuff real quick. We are the only people on at the moment, you and I, Pat. So let's make this and then repair this. So yeah, I wish we could keep the item in our spot here. I just watched Games for Kicks video, and I was inspired to come on here because he showed a great way to ladder. You can go up there, and now where this is full, a great way to increase your levels and then start making better stuff. So if you make a bunch of sticks and then type sticks into the inventory, look at all the stuff you can make. Cobblestone frame, and you make one. Make one of those. Crossbow bolt, make some of those. Make a ladder. And doing this, you should start to level up. Now this stuff we can't make, but let's see here. Oh, and probably nothing else, because we're... And then just get rid of the ladder we'll keep. But you can make little junky stuff and, you know, get your levels up. What level are we anyway? Let's see here. Nope. Map. Nope. Inventory. Character. We're level 4. So once we start getting to like level 5, then we should start doing a little better as far as making. Okay, now let's try to drop this stuff without picking it back up. I really wish they had added a destroy mechanic so that you didn't have to worry about picking stuff up as soon as you got out of the inventory menu. The other problem that we have is that I think our whatever progress we made in pacifying this town has now been obliterated by other people being on the server. So I'm pretty sure that the zombies are now in full force and ready for us. But the good news is we can re-loot stuff. So, and I'm going to continue to scrap these parts because A, they're brown, and two, nice. And two, we don't have the schematic to fix them anyway. Alright, but there have been folks pounding on our house who should have no idea that we are here. But they do. Or at least they have a sense of it. Maybe zombies are very intuitive. That's probably what it is. Very intuitive. Alright, so we need to get out because we need some wood. And we need... because we need to start making this place safe. Because clearly... Listen. Can you hear? Here, let me turn up the volume just a little bit. Like, here-ish. Alright. Because they are... tearing up the joint. Oh, see Fat Man in the house. Fat man, how are you? All I'm just spamming the click button and hoping he can't, he doesn't know to hit up. Whoa, he can do that though. That was a little bit frightening. See, it says we're undetected, but I don't think that's true. I think, and his bloated corpse is gonna be a problem for me, isn't it? Yeah, let's put you there for now. And then put you there for now. Is there somebody else in here? Whoa. We open for business. Oh, another fat man. Can I just, like, smack him in the, Let's see how well this works. Here, let's do this. Here, sir, let me help you. Let me help you stay up there. And take care of the future generations not being born out of this guy. Come on. I think he does a lot of lower body work. Wait, what did you hit over there? Is this actually just doing nothing? I have a feeling it's doing nothing except breaking my club. And I have no, oh, I have no stamina. Hold on. You wait there. I'd shoot him, but... And I want to get over there and close that, because now I got this problem. Okay. Well, that was a failed experiment. Now, can I break this before... I'm infected? You punk. I'm gonna wind up wasting my good arrows on you, jerk. And a lot of them, too. Oh, come now. Okay, so obviously we have a breach down here, which we cannot address with these crappy tools and weapons. So let's just get out and start our day. There goes the neighborhood. All right, everybody be cool. Man, a lot of fat people in the desert. Whew. That was crazy. All right, so obviously we need to get some antibiotics. Because this is just now going to be a problem for us. But we do have the health hamster, as you can see. The little icon there that looks like a hamster. It is telling us that because our food level is up to a certain point, we are generating... Let's see. We are slowly healing. So, that is awesome. Oh, look. There's two of them. Let's see here. Can we deal with it? Their reach is farther than ours. That's the only conclusion I can reach. And I'm gonna get killed by this fool. Yeah, I really do think that the zombies reach bullets and lead. Nice. Does the game not know what lead? How come the loot level is such that I get crappy tools and weapons, but somehow it still thinks I need supplies to make bullets? How about if you're going to level one part of the loot system, you level the rest of it? You know what I'm saying? Just seems to make sense. All right, well... The only thing that is going to... Oh, walking over a cactus is not going to save us. The only thing that's going to save us in life is iron gloves. Okay, now green I'm going to have to keep. but you I'm going to have to wear because I'm gonna be styling. And scrap you. Okay. The ability to find iron arrow tips in the garbage is going to help us a lot. Oh, I was hoping that the game would say, and here's an example of that very thing. Okay, so the infection is going to be wrecking our stamina. Minus 0.3 stamina every second. So it's not enough to actually cause our stamina to go down, but when we're doing things, it will cause our stamina to go down faster. If that makes any sense. So we are just out here gathering some supplies. And hopefully we will be able to make some progress toward getting our base set up properly. Oh, rabbit, I know how you feel. I'm having one of those days too. And I keep hitting I because that is the inventory button for other games. I have remapped it. Okay. All right, so we got scrappy cars and empty weather bags and cactuses that bite. So we didn't really make it too far over to this part of town. There's a nurse. Hello, nurse. Would you happen to have antibiotics? Let's try to make another bow, shall we? Wooden bow. What level are you? Level 43? Level 29. It's better. Oh, and by the way, it's saying entity damage 0. Both on the, I think that's not correct. I think it's just there, it's not displaying correctly because I'm fairly certain that bows have an entity damage of higher than 0. Fat man. Excuse me. Even if they are in the brown zone. Okay, that guy. See, this area is. This must be the where the cool kids live because this area is muy populated. Let's try to find a lonelier nurse. Oh, rustling through the bushes. Always nice. Let's see if we can blow into this garage. At least search it up. And we've got backpack. And I cannot afford to take you. And let's run out of here. Okay, let's see here. We are undetected. Alrighty then. Now the reason I'm here is because there may be some goodness in this safe. But in order to check it out, we gotta get to it. And there ain't nothing to it but to do it. Oh, pro tip, folks. Don't bother trying to go through the door. Go through the ceiling. See what I'm saying? Okay, so this is locked. So I think I have to, like, break it. Yeah, you have to break the lock. Let's see how many rocks this is going to take us. It's probably not the best tool for the job, but when it's the only tool you have. I kind of wish I could leave myself here and then have other me, like, go do other stuff. Oh, and your stamina. Drink a beer. There we go. Let's see, while we're doing this, I could eat a thing. Let's eat some peas. Okay, I will cut away and come back. So be cool. And we're back. And we got nothing. The guys have been telling me that there have been actual guns in the gun safes. Nope, not for us. Not for us. So let's just go through here. You know what? We're just gonna scrap anything. Yeah, I don't want that. I'm gonna scrap that. This I'm gonna scrap. And we're back to having people pounding on our doors. And you go away. Oh, I hate you. I'm running away from my own dropped inventory. Oh! Run, Luke, run! How did you get in here? Is the front door wide open or something? Alright, let's heal up. That was crazy. Paper? Paper? Puts paper in a car. And this is the building that wanted me to think that it was a tool shop. You are terrible. Alright. Let's see here. This place is repopulated again. Oh man, this is gonna be awful. Just terrible. Cause they look, this is our house right here, which they are tearing up for reasons passing understanding, because they're not supposed to be able to target us anymore if we're hidden. Was that, they just blew up a car. I guess you're not spinning on the porch anymore, are you? You're like, I ain't doing that no more, sucker. What's in here? What's in you? Yikes! So, this is all very interesting to learn. So, the struggles of being on a multiplayer server are going to be real. That's a pain. Fat man just spawned in front of me. You have spoiled the immersion, good sir. Was that a bear? Oh, that's planes right there. We are in bear territory. I thought this place was cool. I thought this place was cool because there'd be no bears. So pro tip. If you are living on a multiplayer server, do not try to settle in a point of interest, because the point of interest zombies will respawn and you will not be able to pacify this place fast enough. Give me the hitbox. I ain't got time to look around for it. And it is already going dark. Oh, but I'm going to take all this gasoline. Y'all don't mind, do you? So I wonder if this is a combination of Desert Town and Plains Town. Because if it's a combination, then that means part of it that is a plains town will be able to spawn bears. Don't you know? Okay, yeah. You are all garbage. Garbage, garbage, garbage. And I has no stamina because I'm infected. All right. And it's getting late. So our plan that was so good, it was such a good plan. We were going to come out, start fortifying. You know how we would do in any other alpha. You start in a prefab that you sort of, after you pacify the town, obviously. And then you just start, you build it up, you make it nice and safe. And then you start, you branch out from there, right? That's like how things are done. I don't think that's going to work on a multiplayer server. Because this town's going to keep repopulating almost in between episodes. So I think what we're going to have to do is just start working on a base flat out straight away. And then we're just going to have to use the town to hide in overnight. And to loot. So I think that's what our plan is going to be. You know what I mean? That will work. Because this is no longer my town. Or even our town. This is their town. And it's always going to be their town. So we will have to claim the wilderness. And the spiky bits. So I tell you one thing, I'm not going to feel an ounce bad using woodlog spikes in this map. That's for sure. You know what I'm saying? Cheaty nothing. This is hardcore. We ain't messing around. A perpetual XP farm over there, just waiting to be had. And empty trash all day. All right. So we have a plan. Excuse me. Yikes. We have a plan. And in our next episode, we are going to start executing that plan. But we do need to get some better tools, and that is faux show. And that's going to be the one thing that we're not going to be able to get here. So we may have to go on adventures also, which is going to be tough because we need better stuff in order to go has adventures. Crazy. It's crazy. It's crazy living in the apocalypse. Oh, and gore blocks are now really tedious to get rid of. So I think that doing stuff with water or whatever you can do to keep them from forming is also going to be the order of the day. Yep. It's trouble right here in River City. So I'm going to gather up some supplies, get us ready to go, and then hide for the night. But we have a plan now for this episode, or for this series, at least the first part of it. They kicked us out of our town, but we are going to make them pay for it. Well, if you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to see more, subscribe. If you want to start a conversation, why don't you start one? Where? In the comment section below. Oh, yeah, boy. This is going to be tough. This is hard. It's hard. It's hard. But we'll be fine. Unless there's a bear. Thanks for watching. And have a great day.